afternoon, everybody. Sunday the 3rd of May, and what we're going to be doing today is tomatoes in a bottle. I'll have to look it up. Is it hashtag tomatoes in a bottle, Hugh? I don't know. I'll have to have a look and then I'll put it down at the bottom. And what I'm going to do today is two plastic bottles, and one is going to be my Rose de Berne. We'll see how we get on. And plum tomatoes, as you can see, we have plenty. So we'll do a plum tomato and we shall do a Rose de Berne today and see how we get on. I think I need my glasses, can't see in front of me. Hey Hannibal, can't see a thing. They're not for you. So first of all, we'll take the lid off. And then, I don't want to be cutting. Let's see. I don't want to cut too much of the bottle off because I want to make sure there's plenty of soil in here. And if you're doing this with kids, make sure you go over it with some sandpaper at the bottom, or even put some duct tape or whatever around the sides. And that can also be used as seed sowing. And what I'm going to do with these is get some sweet corn in, because the second sowing of sweet corn, the exact same as last year, have came to absolutely nothing. We've got 3 out about 20. So we're going to be doing that. So let's go and get some compost in here. Now what I'm going to do first is just put the slightest amount of compost in the bottom. Now I did do this 2 years ago. It wasn't tomatoes in a bottle. It was actually upside down tomatoes, what it was called. So I'll put the link down below if you want to have a wee look at that, guys. So what I do first with this small little bit of compost, I'll show you in a minute. Let's grab my Rose de Berne. I do have 2 or 3 of these. Let me see if I can tilt these down a wee bit. There we go. Sit that there for a wee minute. Poke my wee hole in. Like so. Then, gently. Gently, gently. Insert the tomato plant like that. As you can see, there's no compost at the top, so I hold that now, turn it upside down till the compost goes over the top. Before I put any more compost on top of this, what I'm going to do is use some stones gently round about the bottom. And this means when I'm watering and feeding from the top, none of the soil is coming out. I don't need an awful lot of these stones, so let me see. It also holds it in place, as you can see there. And at this stage it is a little bit fragile. But not to worry, because it is pushed in far enough and those roots shall search indeed for the rest of the compost, which I'm going to actually fill up now. So that's almost 3/4 filled, guys, with the compost. A wee row of the chips underneath. That little Rose de Berne is not going anywhere, and eventually all the roots, you'll see it, they'll all come out and cling onto the compost round about and up the sides. So 3/4 filled at the minute, and then I'm going to water it in. There we go. And all I'm going to do right now is just give this a water, because the compost is extremely dry. Turn it round a wee bit. A right good soak. All the excess will enter down the bottom and out, as you can see there. And all I need to do now is top that up. So there we go, that's that one topped up. But I won't indeed water this bit at the top. I'll just leave that slightly drier and I'll just wait. As you can see, that is not touching the tomato plant at all, the water that's coming down, because it is slightly off centre, which is good. So I'll actually just wait until the rest of the excess water comes away from that. Then I'll get a couple of wee holes, probably 3 holes there, and I shall indeed pop it up there on one of the shutters like I did a couple of years ago. And that, my friends, is one rose de beurre. Now I'll go on and I will get a plump tomato in the other bottle and we're good to go. I'll just lay that on its side for the minute. There we go, no problemo. Same again, guys, with the plum tomato. Now, when I did do it a couple of years ago, Hannibal wants to play with the plastic. When I did do it a couple of years ago, I did indeed get some tomatoes, but didn't get an awful lot. But it did work. It did work. So, same again, plum tomato in bottle, third mate. Some compost. A wee shake so it goes in the hole. Same again, light on the side for a wee minute. Try and pick one of the biggest and longest ones here, I think. Loads and loads and loads of these plum tomatoes here, which I shall indeed put on today. Gently does it, Clarice. There's a nice one there. See, some of them are slightly longer, guys. But for the benefit of this little trial and to make it easier, pop that in there. I shall use the stumpier one. And in we go, like so. Hold the neck of the bottle until the soil goes down. And that means it's holding that little tomato plant's roots in at the bottom. There we go. And same again. Same again. Some stones, you can see there. And it's all jam-packed in the neck of the bottle. Let's
chop it up 3/4 full now.
There we go. One plum tomato, 3/4 full. Water it in, nice and tight, and we'll keep those roots in. And just wait to see if there's any excess. That's slowly but surely coming down to the neck of the bottle. So there we go. That's that one watered in. And we'll just finish that off and get some holes in and get them tied up. There we are. We have one plum tomato in a bottle. 3rd of May. Topped up. And if I can just grab the other one. And we have one rose de beurre. For the excess water to come out of the plum tomato. As I said, when you're doing this, don't expect miracles. You're going to get some more tomatoes if you're actually doing this with cherry tomatoes, because they like hanging, don't they? Whereas these ones are rather large. But even if we get 2 or 3, then the experiment works. Job's a good one. Till the next time. Au revoir. To the pup. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.